number 6 to Brian Murphy, making white wine crystal clear. Will you welcome Brian?
What if I told you that that glass of wine that you enjoy was hurting the environment? Would that give you a bad conscience? My research aims to change a process that's over 100 years old. A process that once changed, one will never know has changed. A process whose output will touch the lips of many of you here today and millions worldwide. I want to take these 3 minutes to talk to you about a simple glass of white wine. A simple glass of white wine whose production inefficiency equates the entire white wine production of New Zealand. A production inefficiency that not only equates to a revenue loss of over $1 billion, but worse, emits over 250,000 tons of carbon dioxide into our atmosphere year on year. In an age when we're looking at cars, jet engines, electricity supply grids, even the poor cows in the field are being probed and prodded for their greenhouse gas emissions. Should we not focus on this? I think so. You see, white wine has instabilities, and a major instability responsible for all of this is called protein heat instability. This is where certain pathogenesis-related proteins that get exposed to the stimuli of heat, a simple temperature rise, unfolds and turn an otherwise clear wine hazy. Now, if this was to occur after the bottling process has occurred, it becomes a major concern for producers, as consumers will not purchase a hazy bottle of white wine. So where does one look to solve such a large-scale problem? But to the tiniest of places, to a particle so small that if I was to take a hair in my head, I would have to split it 50 times to get down to its size. A particle so small, it's like staring into a black abyss. I'm creating porous nanomaterials, specifically sized and engineered to remove haze-forming proteins from white wine. To do this, I'm creating a team of special agents. No, not like James Bond, but just as resourceful. I'm creating a team of surface-active agents. These agents are called micellas, and I can create micella structures integrated to a simple particle of sand, sized specifically for the proteins I wish to remove. Furthermore, I'm re-engineering the surface of these particles to give them a thin layer of a supercharge to make them even more strong at removing proteins. Early results show that proteins can be removed, and more importantly, that there are no sensory deleterious impacts to the wine itself, overall making a much more efficient white wine production process. So in the years ahead, on that beautiful sunny day, when you're drinking your cold Chardonnay, think of your clear wine now with a clear conscience. Thank you.